Welcome to Alpha Coding Podcast, an all-access pass to medical coding and billing pro tips that help you start your week off smarter. And now, here is your host, Toni Elhoms.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Alpha Coding Podcast series. I'm your host, Toni Elhoms. Welcome to episode 39 of the podcast. Today is September 28th, and I'm excited for today's episode. I'm going to be covering a topic that isn't on a whole lot of coding professionals' radars, and that is my pro tips for succeeding as an expert witness. So I actually just spoke about this topic to the Allentown, Pennsylvania chapter. Shout out to my friend Victoria Mull. She's the president of the chapter, also over at Contempo Coding. Definitely check out her YouTube channel. She is killing it. And so I wanted to talk about this topic because I got such great reception and feedback, and I thought this would make a great episode. So I'm going to give you some visibility into my work as an expert witness. So before we dive into our topic, it's time for your Monday dose of positivity, the Mindset Monday tip. And it's brought to you by Discount Medical Supply Store. Are you in need of PPE? If so, you're in luck. Discount Medical Supply Store has the lowest prices on all your PPE needs, including N95 masks, respirators, and so much more. Visit our website, alphacodingexperts.com, and head over to the Deals and Discounts tab for a link to take advantage of special pricing on all your PPE needs. So our Mindset Monday tip is all about embracing the struggles that are really inevitable in your journey. We're all going to face struggles and seasons of difficulty. So the quote I want to share with you says, "Maybe you've been assigned this mountain to show others that it can be moved." And this quote really resonates with me because I think we all have those moments where we're like, why me? Why does it have to be so hard for me? And you look at other people and it seems like they've gotten there so easily, or it just happened for them overnight. And it's important to understand that when life gets us down, it's really easy to fall into that trap of being a victim. But shifting your perspective can be incredibly powerful. So it's important to take that perspective and really shift it from why me to why not me? Who else would be better suited for this challenge or this mountain, as it says in the quote? So I think it's important to just pull yourself out of that mindset if you slip into it. And we're all human, so it's a totally normal thing, but I'm telling you what a difference that perspective shift makes. So today we're going to cover my top 10 pro tips for succeeding as an expert witness. So my company, Alpha Coding Experts, is a B2B consulting firm, and we spend about 50% of our time working with physicians and healthcare organizations on the business side of medicine. And the other 50% is spent working with attorneys in the legal sector. So we work with attorneys to detect things like fraudulent coding and billing practices, determine fair market values for services performed in a specific geographic region. We perform complex analyses and even testify in deposition and trial. So we have a network of experts that specialize in all different areas, and we support criminal proceedings as well as civil proceedings. And this work is intense. It's not for everybody. It's exhilarating, but it's also very nerve-wracking. So it's definitely not for everyone. And this brings me to my pro tip number one. Working as an expert is a contact sport. So it is no joke. You are under the highest stakes, the highest pressure, and you really have to be able to perform well. The attorneys, this is what they do every single day. So they're used to arguing, they're used to high stakes communication. So the entire purpose of opposing counsel is to discredit you and make you look like you're not qualified to render expert testimony. So you really have to come prepared and ready for battle, and you have to be able to hold your composure. It's going to be very difficult. Your emotions are going to be running high. Your adrenaline's going to be pumping. This is a contact sport. It feels like you're on trial for murder. That's how intense this stuff is. So you're working with attorneys, and these attorneys are used to arguing and having heated debates and heated, intense discussions about complex topics. So this is something that requires a thick skin. You really have to be able to take the heat and perform well under pressure. You're going to be in front of a lot of people speaking about complex topics, and the entire role of an expert is to simplify it so that lay people that do not work in these industries and these areas, so for me, coding and billing and compliance, I have to simplify this so that they can understand it. An expert's role is to educate so that the judge or the jury can make the most informed decision. Pro tip number two, learn the legal jargon and decorum. So being in the courtroom, talking talking to the attorneys, talking to the judge, talking to the jury, writing reports, all of this stuff requires a certain decorum and also to understand and be able to articulate in the legal language. So much like coding, you have to learn a different language and you have to be able to understand and apply these concepts at a very high level. So much of the legal language is derived from Latin, and I actually took Latin in high school. I took 4 years of Latin. So there's a lot of Latin. You're going to see words like qui tam and ad hoc. So you really have to get to know the legal jargon and also understand the decorum for the courtroom. So there are rules in the courtroom. There are ways to address the judge, the attorneys, the jury. So you have to be able to navigate these rules and the decorum so that you're able to perform as an expert. Pro tip number three, your communication skills must be exemplary. So I'm not just talking verbal, I'm talking written, verbal, and nonverbal, because you're going to be evaluated based on all three of those components. Your credibility as an expert, your ability to explain complex topics in a very simplistic way, your body language, your nonverbal communication, all of this is going to be scrutinized at a very high level. So you have to make sure that you're able to articulate things not only in writing, but also speaking and then controlling your body language. I've seen a lot of people that are able to write these great reports, but when you actually talk to them, they're not able to articulate themselves in the same way. So you have to be able to communicate at an exemplary level in all areas. Pro tip number four, touch every document in your expert file. So obviously there's a lot that goes into being an expert, but when it comes to your file, it's going to be everything that involves the case that you're working on from start to finish. So from the day they contact you until the day that you go and testify in deposition or trial, you need to have touched and have a working knowledge of every single document in that file. Because what's going to happen is opposing counsel is going to have their entire legal team go through every single piece of documentation in that expert file. And you have to be able to speak to every single document in that file. So it's important that you touch every single document in that file and really understand it at an expert level. And preparation is key. So if I'm preparing for a deposition or a trial, you're looking at 60 to 80 hours of prep time that goes into just getting ready for that type of an event. Because these are proceedings where you are recorded under oath. Every single word that you say is documented and can be used against you either today or 10 years from now. So you have to make sure that you're properly prepared. And this is not stuff that you can just start on and then do it for 20 minutes and then hope for the best. You really have to know so much about every single aspect of the case you're working on. Pro tip number five, be mindful of all written communication. So from the day you are retained until the day you go and testify, every single piece of documentation that is written is going to be disclosed potentially to opposing counsel, which can then be used against you. So you have to be mindful of this. Everything that's in writing could be potentially subject to discovery rules. And discovery rules are things that experts really have to know. And it's all based on state laws. So if you're working as an expert in multiple states, which we do, you have to be mindful of the discovery rules in that state. So experts really have to be savvy in all of the discovery rules and absolutely mindful of written communication. I've seen experts get destroyed by things that they've put in writing 7 months ago, and then now they have to defend it and they don't realize that it's incriminating. So it's imperative that you are mindful of written communication. Pro tip number six, never tell a lie under oath. So obviously none of us should be telling lies anyway, but when you are doing a deposition or a trial, you are under oath, which means if you say the wrong thing, if you make a mistake, or if you tell a lie, which all of those things can be construed as a lie, then you can potentially be charged for perjury. You cannot tell a lie under oath. So if you don't know something, you have to say, I don't know. If you don't recall something, you have to say, I don't recall. But you can never lie. You can never make assumptions. You can never opine to something that you don't know to be a fact. So you have to make sure that everything you say you know is 100% true and you can back it up with authoritative sources. Another critical element here is ask questions about the questions that you're asked. So never make assumptions, especially when you're working with attorneys, because sometimes the words that they use are going to be different than what you think they mean, because it means something different to them. So you have to be mindful, because you're in healthcare, but the lawyers are in the legal world. So terminology and semantics are different. So you just have to ask a lot of questions about the questions you're being asked. Pro tip number 7, every word you say matters. Literally every word you say can have a different meaning in the legal language. So if you use the word but or and or therefore, those words have potential meanings that you may not intend. So literally every single word that you say can be used against you. It can be scrutinized. So you have to be mindful. So for example, if you're asked a question and you don't know the answer and you say, I don't know, but then it comes out somewhere in your report or somehow, some way that you did know, that's going to be construed as a lie, that you're not being honest. And those little things can be used against you. So the words really matter. So for example, if you said, I don't recall, that means that you don't remember. So when you say things like, I don't recall, that's really, I don't remember now, but perhaps I do know. So it's imperative that you're really careful with your word choices. Pro tip number 8, a high level of EQ, emotional intelligence, is fundamental. So this is probably the most important skill an expert needs, emotional intelligence. And this is something that can be developed, but it's really the ability to manage your own emotions under pressure and also interpret and kind of have that forethought for other people's thoughts and emotions and the direction that they're heading based on their body language and their communication. So it's a complex thing. It's something that takes a lot of intention and development, but you have to have a high level of emotional intelligence to be able to go to bat with these attorneys, because they're already thinking 25 steps ahead of you. That's how they're trained, and they do this every day. So when they're preparing for a case, they're thinking about all the questions that are going to be asked, and then they're thinking about all the questions that the other side is going to pick apart from their theory. So they're already thinking ahead. You have to train yourself to be able to do that as well at a very exemplary level. Pro tip number 9, be prepared for a Daubert challenge. So the Daubert rule is also something that experts have to be intimately familiar with. But basically, the Daubert rule is all about your qualifications to testify as an expert. So attorneys are going to try to discredit you and challenge you under the Daubert rule, which can require you to testify about certain things with your experience. It can require you to have to respond to reports and challenges. You can also be struck from a trial. So if you are challenged on Daubert, you can potentially have your testimony deemed inadmissible to the court or be struck from the court, which means your expert career is pretty much over. So you have to be really careful, because what will happen is attorneys will try to get you to testify about things that are not part of your expertise, and they do so intentionally to make it look like you're going outside of your expertise box, and then they can use that to discredit you, because an expert has to be very specialized in their field, but they can't go outside of their field. And it's very easy to get pulled into that without realizing it, and then it's too late. So you have to be super careful. Your CV, which is your curriculum vitae, it's not a resume, it's more complex than a resume, is really your way of showcasing your expertise in the subject matter. You have to know that inside and out and be able to testify about every little detail on that CV. Pro tip number 10, you're only as good as your reputation. So experts, the only thing they have to sell is their reputation. Once your reputation is gone, you can never get it back. You will not be hired by attorneys. You will not be able to testify as an expert. So as an expert, you must remain impartial and you must be credible. So you have to remain impartial and maintain that credibility and professionalism no matter what. It's going to be really difficult at times, because attorneys are going to try and attack you. They're going to attack your personal life. They're going to ask you questions that are very uncomfortable. And it's all strategic to try to get you to break under pressure, because once you put it under oath, it can never be taken back. And that is probably the most difficult thing about being an expert. The stakes are so high. There's no margin for error. So I hope that gives you some visibility into my world as an expert witness. Of course, there are so many more tips that we could talk about, but I wanted to keep it short to 10. So grab a pen and paper to summarize my top 10 pro tips for succeeding as an expert witness. Number 1, working as an expert is a contact sport. Number 2, learn the legal jargon and decorum. Number 3, Your communication skills must be exemplary. Number four, touch every document in your expert file. Number five, be mindful of all written communications. Number six, never tell a lie under oath. Number seven, every word you say matters. Number eight, a high level of emotional intelligence is fundamental. Number nine, be prepared for a Daubert challenge. Number 10, you're only as good as your reputation. So it's time for this week's coding pro tip, and it's brought to you by Contempo Coding, which is an on-demand educational resource provider created for coders by coders. They specialize in affordable coding certification prep courses to help you accelerate in your career. Right now, they're offering an exclusive special to Alpha Coding Podcast listeners, and that's $125 off the Certified Risk Adjustment Coding Prep course, as well as some great bonus content when you order through our affiliate website. Visit our website, alphacodingexperts.com, and head over to the Deals and Discounts tab for a link to take advantage of this absolute steal of a deal. If you have a coding related question and would like it to be featured in one of our coding pro tips, please reach out to me on LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube. So this week's coding pro tip comes to us from New York. Hi, Toni. I work in risk adjustment coding, and my company is going through a major reorganization right now, and it involves the organization purchasing a software to automate code abstracting. They have told us that many of our job responsibilities will be replaced by AI in the next year, and many of us could be laid off as the tech is phased in. Do you think that AI is going to replace coders? And what is your best advice for handling this situation? So I really appreciate you submitting this question to the podcast, and I'm sure this has to be an uncertain time for you, kind of knowing what's ahead with this reorg. So I don't think that AI is going to completely replace coders, but I do think that it's going to absorb some of the lower level tasks that coders are currently doing. Things like charge entry, things like basic coding that really can be done through an automated charge master. Those tasks are going to be taken over by bots and AI. I think that coders are definitely going to have to up their game in terms of auditing. I think auditing is going to be a huge area for growth, especially with retrospective auditing in the MRA world, which is Medicare Risk Adjustment world. So I think there's going to be a ton of opportunity for coders to really work in more of a higher level auditing role. And it's important that you retool yourself to be able to succeed in this new economy. It's coming. Change is coming. The days of having a comfy job where you sit and do data entry every day, those days are numbered. And I think a lot of coders really have to prepare themselves and retool themselves for the future. Please remember to hit that subscribe button now so you never miss another episode. Also, be sure to drop us a rating and review on iTunes. We really appreciate your support. So this concludes today's episode. Until next week, thank you for listening to the Alpha Coding Podcast. We'll see you next Monday.
For more information about medical coding and billing pro tips, including how to hire Alpha Coding experts, follow us on LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, or visit our website at www.alphacodingexperts.com.